Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
I'm Kaushika, pursuing intermediate. And since our results have been announced, we students have lots of doubts regarding how to appear for exam and articleship too. And in this session, we believe that our doubts will be clarified and it will be useful for us. And my friends are also here to ask their doubts.
Yes. Good morning, sir. Myself, Haridipak. I'm doing CA Inter.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Jay. I am doing my CA Inter.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Lydia Jayasri, pursuing CA Inter.
Yes, you can ask your questions.
Can people change from group old scheme to new scheme, sir?
Okay. This doubt mainly because of this attempt going to be a lost attempt for the old IP3 students. Many of them having the same doubt whether I can change the old scheme to new scheme, IP3 intermediate or not. Always remember, it is not advisable to change from old scheme to new scheme. Already have written IPCC, just because of the percentage of result or just because of question may be easy for inter, this type of perception is not correct. Previous attempt, if you wrote IPCC, the same stream only you have to follow. Don't change the scheme. Remaining fraud, you are having 90-95 days only for the effective preparation. So by this time, if you are going to change the scheme, you will get the confusion. And accordingly, changes in syllabus also there. For example, intermediate, FM part will be there, economics part will be there. So economics for finance is there. So everywhere, little changes are there. It's not the right time to change the old scheme, right time to change from old scheme to new scheme. Old scheme itself advisable. Finish it off. This attempt is the last attempt for you. Therefore, you no need to worry. If I failed in this coming attempt, what can I do? That all not right here. That circumstance we can decide, it's not the time for you to change the scheme. So, always advisable to go as per the existing scheme only. Yes, sir.
Is there any impact in changing exams?
No. It's so many years, decades, they are all of them having the same doubt. Just because I am changing the exam center, result will be there or not. Absolutely not correct. Few of them having the doubt, I am in metro, sir. I will go to place like what, small town, Coimbatore or Salem. I will write the exam, I will change the center so that in that particular jurisdiction, my presentation will be better than all persons are there in the exam hall. It's practically not correct. Center-wise valuation is not there. Centralized valuation, total paper only they are going to value. Doing the valuation, valuer may not aware which region's paper or which student's paper. Therefore, because of changing center, absolutely there is no impact with respect to research. It's a psychological failing only. It's always advisable to write the exam where you are comfortable, which area you are comfortable. It is always advisable to write the exam where your parents are there so that some supports will be there for the purpose of preparation and during the examination time also. During examination preparation late night, if you are not going to feel well or one day your health issue, you are going to affect the health issue, somebody there should be there to support you. Therefore, it is not advisable to change the examination center. Because of changing examination center, there is no impact at all. Yes.
Sir, I have cleared my group 1 exams,
so
whether I have to join articleships now or after completing my group 2 exams?
Yes, that's why many occasions I am giving the advice. It is always advisable to join pre-articleship. Pre-articleship represents what? The moment you wrote the examination, you have to join for the articleship. Even though effective registration is going to start from after you clear the intermediate group 1. But after declaration of result, if you are going to join, for you, remaining group pending means group 2 if you are going to write, then preparation time is going to get affected. If you prepare both the groups in this attempt, immediately you are forced to join articleship. If you are going to clear first group alone and the second group is pending means, then you are eligible to join the articleship. Yes, if you have to join the articleship, but at the same time, if you are going to join the articleship now, we are in the February month. Feb, March, April, May month examination. At least you need 1.5 to 2 months. Study holiday, at least 1.5 months to 2 months you need study holidays. Therefore, you are going to join in February, immediately March and April if you are going to ask the exam, it's very difficult. Working for only 1 month, that as soon as you join for the articleship, no principal going to give the leave. Therefore, that problem will come the immediately if you are going to join the articleship. So you have to join the articleship, you have to plan in well in advance, you have joined the articles by way of pre-registration or pre-articleship. It is not the right time to join the articleship if you are having one group pending. So better you can concentrate one group because getting leave from the articleship is difficult. So finish the group 2, Immediately after that, you can join that. After writing the group D examination, very next day, better you can join the articulation. That would be advisable.
Sir, is pen drive classes advisable?
It is always, nowadays, everybody going again online class or pen drive class. Even we are also selling online as well as pen drive class and all. But with respect to education or teaching wise, it's always preferable to go for live class only. Always preferable to go for live class. So that the impact will be much more better. But if left with no choice, if you want to save the traveling time or you may have some other work and that same appointed time you're not pushing to come to that class, or after a particular point of time you are going to balance career as well as job as well as what education, those circumstances, or married woman, they want to pursue the course, those circumstances, is a pen drive class is also advisable. Clear? So pen drive class is a, it's not what we got the option to replace the main class, live class. Always prefer to go for the main class. If not possible, worst come worst situation, or repeaters, they can be the option to go for the pen drive class. But pen drive class always will need some self-discipline. Here mean there are the faculty will be there, whether you are concentrating properly or not, you forced to complete that particular portion, then only you have to leave. But in case of pen drive class, if you don't have the self-discipline, very difficult for you to what? Acceptance level will be very less from the student side. Okay?
I wrote my group 1 exam, IPCC, in November 2019, sir. Unfortunately, my result was failed. At this point of time, I have only 2 months for preparation. Is this advisable to write both the groups that and it is my own personal plan to concentrate on group 1 and the second group if I have one exemption, so that is that advisable to go further or should I write concentrate in both groups?
That's why yesterday I released one video, how to overcome the failures. For that, in that I have given all exam tips or study plan also. Many of them having this type of what assumption, we'll write the group, we'll concentrate group 1, we'll pay the fees for both the group, and next to group I'll go and attend, at least I'll get try to get exemption on paper. That is not advisable at all. Clear? Even if you are going to try to get the exemption, definitely there is no definite circumstance you will get the exemption. Instead of wasting the time for even that one particular paper, suppose you are writing group 1 and a group 2. In group 2, ITSF you want to get the exemption. What is the guarantee we are going to get the exemption? In that particular time, whatever you are going to spend for preparation time for ITSM, if you are going to concentrate group 1, you may have finished the group 1 itself. So many students, neither in the position to get the exemption, nor in the position to clear the group 1 because of aggregate, they are unable to clear both the groups. So before you are going to pay the application money, always remember, always plan properly whether you are going to write both the group or single group. Understood? That is always advisable. No sir, I will try my best in that circumstance. It is always advisable. Group 2, you can prepare after writing all the group 1 paper. Don't touch the group 2 paper now. Prepare group 1, finish it off. And the remaining time after writing the group 1, the one day before the examination, try your level best so that you can complete little. And if you are going to try, that may be what experience for you. Not now. If you are going to prepare from now onwards, instead of 4 paper, you are going to prepare 5 paper, then it's very difficult. So better concentrate only one group. If you are mentally prepared to get one exemption in second group, don't do like that. Either both the group or single group, you have to decide out, sir. Okay? For that, you need study plan.
Sir, will the retotaling have any chance to
produce? Yeah, retotaling. Many students may not aware, because many students used to tell, no, retotaling, there is no impact, same mark will come. Not like that. During the almost 14-15 years of my teaching experience, till now I come across more than 90 of my own students, 90 students, because of retotaling, they clear the examination. It may be group 1 or group 2 or inter or final, clear. Based on retotaling itself, they clear the exam. But many of them telling what, no, retotaling, same total will come. Yes, if you are going to see 10 people, 9 people may be going to get that same total, there is no change in total, same failure. But 1% there, even the 10% chances are there. If you are confident with respect to that particular paper, I wrote properly, sir, then chances of committing valuation side also little possible. If there is a mistake in valuation or totaling, definitely they will award, chances are there. Even 10% chance, you don't need to miss out. Provided you know very well which paper you are not going to get the good mark, which paper you wrote properly. If you are having that confidence, definitely you can go for pre-totaling. Pre-totaling also advisable. Okay?
So, any important questions relating cost and proposal?
Important topics.
Oh,
yes, with respect to important topics for costing, which topics you have to concentrate for the coming examination, that I can tell. For costing concern, material costing, labor, process costing, marginal costing, activity based costing, standard costing, and cost sheet. Those areas called the A category item for the coming examination. Concentrate those areas so that first priority give to those areas so that you will have a chance to cross more than 40 to 50 marks. And always remember, without studying theory, don't go enter on any topic. Theory part also equally important. Yes.
So is LMR sufficient to appear for examination?
You are talking about book LMR. Law Spirit Revision book. Yes. It is always advisable to refer the ICA material. ICA material, there is no substitute for our institute material. Since for the new scheme, we don't have practice manual question, practice manual book. LMR book may be useful for your preparation. Even last time also many questions came. In LMR book, all past exam questions I have included, and that too, even recent RTP, MTP, everything has been included, past exam, RTP and MTP. And those books also will tell what are the questions you have to study. Beyond that, nothing will come. LMR, we can trust on the LMR. Even both theory as well as practical problem, LMR costing would be sufficient.
Sir, what are the important topics in FM paper?
FM paper. In FM, you have to concentrate working capital management properly, source of finance theory part properly, capital budgeting, risk analysis in capital budgeting, and capital structure theory. These are all the areas you have to be pakka. Coming examination, leasing problem may not going to come. With respect to leasing, theory portion alone you can study, that is sufficient. Okay, these are all the topics for coming examination, May 20 examination. Hope I clarified all the doubt. Okay? Good.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.